A heartbroken father has revealed his shock and anger at learning his child is one of the 7 preschoolers allegedly abused by a family's SA carer. The case was back in court today, but the intensive work needed to prepare the prosecution means the accused man won't be required to answer the charge for more than another month. Phoebe Bowden has this exclusive report.
The families at the centre of the case, which rocked the state, are still trying to get a grip on the enormity of the allegations.
Worst thing you've ever heard in your whole life that you would never expect.
Police allege 7 preschoolers in state care were molested by a family's SA residential carer. As the 32-year-old faced court today, one parent recounted the awful moment he was told of the arrest.
It is really hard to describe the hurt and the anguish and the pain of the whole situation.
Prosecutors have announced that after 3 months of sifting through electronic files, which allegedly contained thousands of child pornography images, they've finally finished gathering evidence. But it won't be until late November that the accused carer finally responds to the charges.
We feel that's enough to keep us going. We understand it's going to be a long process. It's going to take a long, long, long time to come to an appropriate decision.
The father is angered, though, by family's SA, who he claims has shown an inconsistent approach to his family, deeming him capable of looking after some of his children and not others.
I just kept fighting, and that's the best thing that you can do.
The suitability of residential carers still within the system is under review. Concerns were raised about the employment records of more than 100 of them in a high-level investigation launched after this carer was charged. Phoebe Bowden, 10 Witness News.
Adelaide researchers could arm the world with the weapon needed to stop the spread of Ebola within months. A highly specialised team at Flinders University is racing to develop a vaccine for the US military to put into human trials using technology to shortcut the process, which normally takes a decade. Phoebe Bowden has this exclusive report.
Ebola is the killer modern medicine has been powerless to stop, but Australian researchers armed with a supercomputer hope to do the almost impossible.
So we're taking gene information, which is publicly available on the web, feeding that into our supercomputer, designing appropriate proteins and using them as vaccines.
The technology is safer than traditional testing and development as it doesn't involve exposure to the virus.
And so there's no virus involved in the whole process, and obviously Ebola is a highly lethal virus and you need very specialised facilities to handle the virus.
The US military does have those facilities. It will take over human trials of the vaccine once it's developed. Traditionally that process takes 10 to 15 years. These researchers plan to be done in just months.
In 2009, this group of researchers rolled out a swine flu vaccine in just 10 weeks. It hopes to have an Ebola vaccine in clinical trials by early next year.
Here we have a humanitarian crisis in Africa that's getting worse by the day, and the only thing that's really going to impact on that is a successful vaccine. So in this case, we don't have years to develop the vaccine.
The latest Ebola outbreak has already claimed 4,500 lives. A vaccine is the best option as the disease is usually already lethal by the time symptoms show.
Part of the problem is it's a stealth virus. It has learnt methods to hide itself from the immune system.
Phoebe Bowden, 10 Witness News.
The godmother of Chloe Valentine has wept as she revealed how the little girl herself cried for help to be rescued from her abusive mother, now jailed over her daughter's death. But she told the coroner after repeatedly reporting the child's neglect for more than 4 years, she lost faith in family's SA and gave up. Phoebe Bowden continues our coverage of the inquest that has child protection agencies firmly under fire.
Piercing screams from a helpless little girl, a disturbing reaction to being returned to her mother after staying with friends. Chloe Valentine's godmother, Crystal Bennick, gave the coroner a chilling insight into the fearful life she lived. She told me she hated her mother at 3 years old. But Chloe's cries for help would never be loud enough. So too those of her godmother. Ms. Bennick broke down as she told the court she contacted government agencies numerous times, but her pleas fell on deaf ears. Ashley Polkinghorn laughed as her daughter repeatedly fell off a motorbike she and her partner forced her to ride until she died. They're behind bars for Chloe's manslaughter. Ms. Benning told the coroner she lost faith in Families SA and eventually didn't bother reporting. I'd given up on them after 4.5 years of them doing nothing.
Another witness revealed Chloe's mother and her then partner subjected her to a form of torture. She was locked in a room and watched on video, crying and trying to escape.
Account after account was given to the court of Polkinghorne's abuse and neglect. A little girl covered in dirt and vomit and smelling of cannabis. On one occasion, Chloe was so frail and dehydrated, her godmother rushed her to hospital. A social worker there reported it to Families SA, but still Chloe wasn't removed. And the court heard there was a long list of extended family and friends who would have happily taken the little girl in, had they been given the chance. Families SA witnesses will start giving evidence tomorrow. Phoebe Bowden, 10 Eyewitness News.